Hey guys, what's up? What's going on? Yo, Cater here on a beautiful, beautiful day. Pound that for watching this video. Pow! So, I'm here in the office doing some thinking. I was actually strategizing, making some stuff happen, creating some plans. So I decided, hey, let's go live inside of the group. I haven't been live in here in a couple of, maybe in a week or so. We've done a couple of webinars, so welcome to all of you that's coming in. Got a lot of people coming in during the week. A lot of people doing a good job. A lot of people just crushing it to the next level. So I decided, hey man, let me just go live and give you guys some advice into strategizing a game plan. Now, if you're running a business online, strategy is the key, right? You got to be able to strategize your winning, your game plan, and your winning. How you going to win at this game? Because if you're looking to build a long-term business online, you cannot go in without a strategy, okay? You cannot go in without a game plan. So what's going on if you're watching live, okay? So what I want you to take out of this video today, guys, is to learn how to strategize your game plan. Yeah, with strategy, it's not just tactic. You don't want to become tactical in your business, okay? What's going to happen with a lot of people with different tactics that you might be taught, maybe it's Facebook, maybe it's YouTube, maybe it's Craigslist. What's going on, Michael? What's going to happen? To the fill of time, some stuff happened and then maybe your ad account got shut down. You know, maybe your Craigslist ad account gets shut down. Maybe your YouTube gets shut down. If you rely just on tactic, you're going to quit. You're going to quit your business. Maybe Facebook did not approve any one of your ads. So if you just rely on just a tactic, well, you're going to quit. Talking about tactic earlier, I spoke to one of my good friends who's actually inside of the group, John Chapman, and he was telling me how, which I see a lot of people is getting their Facebook account get shut down because of, you know, the flood of money promotion that we was doing. So, you know, if you can stay away from showing too much money, if you do have proof, you can just show it in your computer. That's great. Facebook don't really like this, the whole money promotion, you know, the pushing of money. So we kind of slow down on that. But if you're pushing that, although it converts great, but at the same time, if you want to push your business long term, you definitely want to find other ways to push it. Which, if you have the proof on your computer, it's almost the same thing. It's just, I don't know, money just has some type of effect on it. Like, people just love to see it. It's crazy. I don't know why. Although you could show it in the screen, but when people see it, for some reason, they just feel like it's real, you know. But anyway, either way, we're talking about strategizing your plan and just not relying on just tactic. What's going on, Corey? What's going on, some of you that's coming in live? So what's going on, Rosali? Desmond in the house. So guys, strategizing your plan. That's why I use different strategy. If you see the way that I market, you know, I have different strategy of marketing. You know, I have Facebook pulling traffic on one side, I have YouTube pulling traffic on another side, and then I have Craigslist in the back end. So most of my traffic lately has been coming from Facebook and YouTube, which is why I create my own funnel. Someone asked me earlier about how can I create my own funnel. FB is easy to get banned. Yeah. Yeah, but that, don't let that stop you. You know, I'm getting banned with so many different things, guys. I mean, it's a system, you know. Don't get too much into your feelings. You know, that happens with so many people who are trying to build their business. And if they get shut down or something happened, maybe PayPal shut them down, Facebook shut them down, and they get into their feelings and they feel, oh, maybe I'm running a scam, but it's not really. Because they have different policy. You know, they have policy violations and different stuff. I had an account that got shut down and I appealed it and they gave me my account back. So, I mean, different system has different, you know, foundation. They have different violations and different stuff. So don't let that stop you from building your future, your dream. So you don't want to be tactical, but you want to, someone says that. But you want to have experience, right? You want to strategize your game plan, okay? Like my game plan every single day, if you go on YouTube, you're going to see that I post a video every single day. Every day of the week. And people might say, yo, Cater, it takes me a long time. I don't want to do videos, but I want to get my message out there. You know, my videos are like 4 or 5 minutes long. Then some of them are 20 minutes long. You know, to some people that don't want to build their business that way, that's cool. But it's a free strategy. It's a free way. When I was doing Craigslist, I would just post 2 or 3 ads every single day. Because remember, it's not the tactic that matters, right? It's how you strategize yourself, right? When you get the people from YouTube, how do I strategize them to go to the funnel? What am I going to do with the traffic? What am I going to do with the leads? How can I get conversion? What can I do on my end to help my business grow? Are you going to do a webinar? Are you going to do a Facebook Live? Maybe talk to your few team or get a few people together that's on your list and just explain to them. Maybe they might have questions that they might even answer. Can you just put something together? Like, start thinking as an entrepreneur. Don't think as a job. I know a lot of people see this thing and they think it's a job. You are now officially an entrepreneur, right? You are 1099. You create your own opportunity. You create your own future, okay? Don't depend on me, even though I'm your sponsor, but don't depend on me, right? Because I have to run my business. You know, you got to run your business. That's why we strategize, you know? Like, in the past month, my team has over 600 people. So I sponsored 600 people. I mean, that's record time for me. The last time I did something like this was 2 years ago when I was promoting. No, 3 years ago when I got into a company. I haven't done a type of network marketing. I mean, MCA, the way we do it is kind of more all online. I haven't done a team building. Let's say I haven't done team building in 3 years. Last time I did that, I was able to get 250 in a month. And now, I mean, this is my record time right now to get 600 people on a team in just a month for me. So, I mean, 600 people, if I'm thinking tactical, right? So many of you are sending me questions in the inbox every single day. How can I help you run your business if I need to run mine, right? So, it's crazy. Like, when you start building a team that's huge, you guys will understand that you have to be able to leverage. You have to be able to understand strategy. That's why I have a team training site. That's why I have the Facebook group. You guys can just drop your questions. Anyone can see it and anyone can help. Okay, you guys can go to the training site. I don't have to hold your hands. You can watch the training. Boom, boom, boom. You do whatever it says and you get results. I have someone in the team right now and he's my top guy. I never even spoke to him. It's funny. You know, he called me up the other day. He's like, dude, you don't pick up your phone. Like, he's been sending me messages because my stock message is like 2,000. I hired a VA. I had a virtual assistant still going through my message. I have like 2,000 messages behind. I mean, it's literally nuts and crazy. So, you know, he's been sending me messages. I haven't been able to see them because I haven't seen my stuff. And then when I look into the back office, he sent me a message. He texted me. And when he texted me and I saw that he was getting, I think he's getting like 20 signups a day now. Joe, I mean, he find this niche where he's literally killing it. I haven't really spoke to him fully. Let me see. Look for his name real quick. Maybe I can give him a shout out on this. Yeah, his name is Joe Lever. I mean, you can see, flip this thing on my page. This is him, Joe Lever, if you're inside of the group. I mean, he got like 20 signups. And he's the guy who's just crushing it. And I never spoke to him. And that's what I want you to realize is that when you go out there, you start experimenting with your business. All you need is a blueprint. Okay, take the blueprint and then start running. Okay, start strategizing on how you can do things better. Here's a secret. Set out 5 things that you can do for the day. Okay. Like a lot of you, you must understand, you are a business owner. You're running a business. What am I going to do today that's going to propel my business forward? How am I going to get traffic, leads? If you don't do these things daily to get traffic and leads and start converting, you're not running a business. You know, you can post nice things on social media. That's not running a business, okay? You might just talk to a few people. That's not running a business. You must have strategy. When you're running a business, you must have daily strategy that's gonna enable you to get more traffic. Like I said to you earlier, some of my daily strategy, I make a video every single day. My videos, they drive traffic. Okay, it wasn't so in the beginning, you know, but as I progress, I start making noise, people start seeing this stuff, and every single day, now I'm getting 150 leads for free. every single day on YouTube, even without doing a thing but a video. But it started in the beginning at zero. We all start at zero. I started at zero. You're gonna start at zero. Whatever strategy you're starting is gonna be at zero. When I was posting Craigslist ads, I was posting one ad a day, two, three, four, five, and I started getting like 10 leads. And then I started posting a lot more. Then I started getting 400-500 leads a day on Craigslist. But I started at zero. Everybody starts at zero. Whatever you're gonna be building, you're gonna start from the bottom. More likely, you're not gonna have the following. More likely, you're not gonna have nothing to start with but the ground. But if you're gonna build this business, you can't let that stop you. So you gotta strategize your daily action. Have what's called a daily action plan, okay? I preach on that stuff every single day. This is my daily action plan. This is my book that I actually set what's gonna happen for the day. You can see that? Like, I have things, I write them down. What am I gonna do for today, okay? If you don't have a blueprint, more likely you're gonna end up just going around. Even if you have 2 hours to run your business, let it set for that 2 hours. Am I gonna make a 5 minutes video and then upload it on YouTube? That's another thing. Am I gonna send an email to my list? Am I gonna host a training webinar to them? Am I gonna do a Facebook group where I invite people and kind of tell them what this stuff is about? Are you showing us how to spend? Shami said, okay, are you showing us how to spend $100 and turn it into $1,000 still? Am I still showing you how to do that? I showed you how to do that. It's on the training. It's on the training site. If you go, Shaheem, if you go on the training site, you learn this stuff. The key is you got to do it. Now, when I say that, hey, I spend $100 and I make $1,000, it's not all the time. All the time, it's not going to be the case all the time. Sometimes I spend $1,000 and make less. Or sometimes I spend, you know, it's all come with testing and strategizing. But the possibilities are there. Just like I showed you, this guy who's a newbie, he just came in and he took action. And he's getting 20 signups a day. I mean, newbie just getting started into this thing, you know. But you're going to have, everybody has different stories. Now, can I say, hey, because this guy is a newbie, he got 20 signups a day, I'm going to be a newbie and I'm going to spend $10 and get 20 signups a day? More likely that ain't going to happen, you know? So everybody have different, hey, what's up, John? My man, John, you know, follow this guy. He's one of my mentors I follow for the longest. I mean, John's seen my uprising in this industry, how it all started, man. I mean, we all have a story. So don't come with no knowledge, no understanding, no skill set, and think that you're gonna be a millionaire overnight. It doesn't work that way. We cannot skip the grind, okay? But understand that you're in the process of learning, and if you strategize, if you learn day by day, okay, you are growing. Even though you might be failing for a second, there's a lot of stuff I know you don't know. The people you see that's getting a lot of results, there's a lot of stuff they know that you don't know. So you gotta give yourself time to accumulate the information and to grow. Okay, I made one sale, but I spent a lot of money on ads and can't seem to get a single lead. You might be doing something wrong, man. If you spent a lot of money, Shaheem, now the question is, how can you figure out what you're doing wrong? Take a step back and look at your funnel, okay? If you're getting a lot of traffic, you're not getting leads, if you a lot of people's coming to your stuff, maybe your funnel is not right. Maybe your capture page is not right. Maybe your call to action is not good. So if you're spending in him, here's one thing. Like, I know there's a lot of people who just come into this thing here right now. What is a lot of money? I know to a lot of people, if you haven't spent $1,000 in Facebook ads, you haven't spent money. I mean, let's be for real. I spent 10 G's on Facebook ads in about a week. I mean, I know a lot of you would say, yo, Kater, you have the fun, now you can do that. But what I want you to understand that is that what you consider a lot of money, when you're building a business, how much money does Coca-Cola, you know, this big industry, how much money they spend in their business? You got to start thinking, okay, how much money is a lot of money? When you're trying to acquire $80 sales, like I did a video just a couple of days ago, run this like a business, not like a job, not like a get rich quick or get a quick money here. You're going to see the value. Because I'm willing to spend $60 to get an $80 sale. Because you got to understand profit. It's a profit-based model. When you run a business, you're not working per hour anymore. You're not trying to make $100 for today. That's not the case. You're trying to make $10,000 for the month. You're trying to make 20. It's not like a job. Like, I'm not trying to make, you know, $500 here for the whole week or for the whole month. You gotta base it into a profit-based model business. That's why if you're starting a business, go find yourself some capital. You need to have some operating capital. Because if you have a funnel, if you have some traffic and it's converting, you got one sell, you should be able to scale up to start getting 10, 20 sell and start doing your numbers. But if you don't have capital to start running it like a business, you're going to get stuck and waiting to get, you know, you're going to have to wait till MCA maybe pay you and then put in some money. If you run a business, you must have operating, you must have starting capital. Okay, so just getting an offer, like, you know, you get started with MCA. Some of you is like, yeah, okay, I just spent my last $40 to get in. I don't have anything else. So my advice to all of you, right, if you're trying to do things that way, okay, you can go to Craigslist. This is how I did it in the beginning. I'm not going to be a hypocrite and say, hey, you know, I started where I had money to invest. I didn't. You know, that's when I started. I made videos, which is free. You know, I went on Craigslist and I post a lot of ads, you know, and drive traffic that way, which is free. And I did postcards. I got myself a bunch of business cards. And then when I go to parties or when I go any places, I start giving it out to people. I go to Walmart. I started breaking sweat to get this thing going. So here's two things. If you don't have money, you're going to have to leverage you. You're going to have to leverage your own energy and go out there and, you know, hustle and get things going. If you have the money, you can let money work for you. Now, a lot of people don't want to invest money into themselves or their business, you know, which is the worst thing that you can do. Because if you want this business to give you the lifestyle you're looking for, yo, caterer, I want to travel, I want to work from home, I want to be with my kids, I want to live the life of my dream. And what's going to make it happen? Not my job, obviously, because my job sucks. I don't want to be there. I hate working there. I want a different life. Okay, this is why I'm trying to do this business thing. So, if the business is what's supposed to give you that lifestyle, why should you be afraid to spend into it? You know, why should you be afraid to spend? Like, people easily go to school and they get a student loan for $5,000 for a class that they're gonna go two times a week for 3 hours a week. They sit in a class, and literally they probably will never use that information ever in their lifetime. How do I know? I did it. I went to school where I literally had classes, certain class like how to get around campus 101. Really? And I had to pay for it. And I went to an expensive school. Like, one credit was like almost $1,000. So my classes was like $3,000 per class. So I was taking, you know, the you know how the deal goes. You know, but I'm saying it didn't hurt at that moment because it's been drilled in our mind. Education is important. And you know, we need to do what we gotta do and pay for these classes and pay for college. If your business, you gotta bring it up to that category. Right now, you're dealing with a business who can make you thousands of dollars a month. You know, I mean, I have people who's making 10 G's. I have people who's made like, you know, $20,000 last month. So is it possible? Yeah. My online business right now is hitting 7 figures. Is it possible? Yeah. So what you must understand is that if this is what's gonna give you, if this is the business, the thing that's gonna give you the freedom that you're looking for, everything that you're looking for, I must be willing to spend at least a couple of G's. What was the last thing? What was the, you know, let me ask you this. What was the biggest spending that you made from, I don't know how old you are. A lot of you might be different ages on this, watching this video inside of the page, inside of the group. What was the biggest amount of money that you spent? You know, whether it's last month, you know, whether it's last year or 3 years ago, whatever. You know, if it was your rent, if it was your house, if it was your you bought a TV or whatever, you know, I want you to match your business spending to that. And until you spend that much on your business, do not consider yourself running a business. I mean it literally. Like, the way that you spending without strategy. You have the strategy. Now, it's that you have to be willing to take that strategy and work it. Because in that training site, guys, if you go, even if you start from the beginning, right? If you go into the part that's not advanced, you just go, oh, I'm just gonna set up, just drive traffic to the funnel that's already given to me, you know, start making some money. Now, if you really wanna take it to the next level, you jump into the advanced stuff that I teach in there, create your own capture page. You cannot lose. When you create your own capture page, you get your own leads, you get your own traffic. Even if you decided, hey, tomorrow, like, you know, and next year, I'm gonna quit this opportunity, I got my traffic, I got those leads. I can send out an email right now and get to 10,000, 20,000 people that I got them from Facebook. I got them from Craigslist. I got them from wherever, YouTube. So that money that you're spending, it is not lost because you win even in the front end and the back end. You know, front and back. So it's a long-term process. You got to understand strategy, okay? If you learn how to strategize this, how many of you here, let me ask this question here because I've just been babbling here. How many of you are looking to build this business, your business, your online business? How many of you are looking to build it long-term? Like, you're not looking to just get a quick $80 this month, or you're not looking to get a quick $80 this week. You're looking to build, like, long-term. Like, you're looking, like, 5 years down the line, you have a business that's thriving. You're looking, like, you know, 10 years down the line, you have something that is sustainable where you can literally go on vacations and do whatever you want, and you can have a personal brand that literally making you multi-million dollars a year, and you don't have to worry about money ever again. You're worrying about more of your passion, the stuff that you really want to accomplish in life, and you're making this stuff happen. Leave a comment down below. I just want to know how many of you that's like, you know, you're looking like long term, because these people, okay, Shaitan says me. I don't think at least 100 just in MCA within a month. I'm a total of at least $100 within a month. Okay, if you spend $100, someone say you just spend $100, 50K per month. John says, yeah, I'm looking to get 50K per month, long-term assets, cash flow. Exactly, leverage, commercial, real estate, powerful. Yo, take that money. And that's the thing, you gotta understand, you know, leverage and diversify your income. You know, it's one of the things I learned from my mentor. The online base changes so much. If you stay in here, you learn the skill set, right? You're able to get the money. Take that money from online, invest it into tangible assets offline. Buy yourself a couple of apartments. You know, start growing stuff that move a little bit less faster, because the internet changed so fast, so much. Like today, Facebook could be working with you. Next week is just like down. Today you could be doing e-commerce and you have this new platform, everybody's talking about it. Everybody's talking about Shopify or whatever, doing this and that, Amazon or whatever, eBay, you know. Things are working, and then in a minute it changed. So what you need to do is to stay on the grind, learn the information on the internet, learn how to build a multi-million dollar business online, and then take some of that money and then invest it into offline stuff. Stuff that are less, you know, that moves less faster, you know, the more stable, you know. So diversify your income is definitely gonna be long term. Okay, Shaim said, yo, I spent $100 in Facebook ads and you made one sale. So you spent $100 and you made Facebook ads and then you made one sale. So you made $80 back. You in the loss for $20. So in the loss for $20, I wouldn't call it loss because you got the traffic, the leads, which is not loss, because if you have the traffic and the leads, if you have your own autoresponder, you're not losing. You haven't lost anything. So $100 and you made one sale, so that's not losing to me at all. Like I said, in the beginning, I'm always willing, because you gain experience. You know, after you spend that $100, you understand how traffic works. You understand how Facebook works. You know, it's like us going to college, man. We amass all this debt and we got nothing. Like 4 years straight, all you get is the experience, like college experience, the book. You made no money. Like I went to college for like 7 years. I literally made $0 off my investment. So always understand when you come into this business, I have not seen anything that can create profit as fast. Like although you spend $100, you made $80. You think about those people who's going to school and spend thousands of dollars and you not see, not even a zip. So what you need to understand is the fact that, hey, you gain experience, okay? Now, from the experience that I've gained, from the data that I've gained, I'm gonna move forward now, getting better. Okay, now I'm getting traffic and leads now. Okay, what I need to work is, how do I convert those traffic and leads? Okay, now people are coming to my ads now. Where do I need, what's the next step? How do I convert them? How do I build? Because what I'm teaching you guys in this group, you know, it's how to build long term. Because I've been doing this like for 5 years, guys. I haven't worked a job in the last 5 years. Has it always been sweet? No, there's ups and downs, but it's my journey, man. I'd rather that than go on a sleeve and give somebody else my time, my experience, and build something for my family. So I want you guys to understand that you're building a business that has the potential of giving you the freedom that you're looking for. You're building a business long term that, you know, for right now, if you acquire the skill set that you need, long term down from now, you don't have to worry about income because you understand how to create it. You know, you'll become a money machine. You know, I remember seeing a video of one of my mentors talking about this thing called stupid money, okay? And I forgot his name. And he talks about how he would go on vacation and spend like, you know, $2,000 on this vacation and come back to find the money come right back to him. You know, and his name is Rob Ford. He was part of a company that I was part of when I was getting started. And literally, you know, he was explaining this stuff. It made no sense to me at that moment. I'm like, dude, like, how do you get stupid money? He's like, yeah, you go, you spend that money, and you spend 2 G's on vacation or 3 G's, whatever, and then you come back before your vacation is over. It's like that money comes right back to you. So, and the way to do that is to be able to create that cash flow. And once you create that cash flow where money comes to you continuously with no problem, you understand, you build that brand. Like I said, make videos. And right now, like, YouTube is kicking up like big time. I can literally just sit back and make a video. You know, every single day I'll be making at least 2 G's, at least 2 G's with my YouTube, just from YouTube without the back end money. I mean, I'm talking about back end. I make way more in the back end than the front end, but just with YouTube ads. But it took me a time to learn, okay, to grow. You know, I couldn't do it overnight. I would love to do it overnight. I'd love to give it to all of you that's here overnight, but it's not gonna happen. That's why you gotta become a strategist. You gotta start strategizing, and as you start growing, you start strategizing more, you start growing, and everything will start falling into place, man. So guys, I just wanted to hang out here with you guys. I got some stuff to get done. So if you guys have any questions, appreciate all of you that's in this group. We're looking to grow and explode. Kind of, you know, this thing kind of fall in the right time for me. So I believe all of you that's in here, if you guys take this stuff seriously, you guys are gonna be winners. You guys are gonna crush it, man. First thing, you gotta work on your mindset is the most important thing. If you guys don't quit, you guys keep persisting, you keep learning, you keep falling forward and make stuff happen. You know, I can promise you, you know, there's people right now who's making it happen in a very, very short time because we have stuff that now that we have access to. Then when I got started, you know, I didn't have access to. You guys have access to these things. And it's the same thing. I used to be the one on the other end of those videos watching my mentors talk about, oh, you guys are so lucky. You guys got funnel. When I got started, all I had was WordPress, and I had to bang my head on the computer, like, trying to figure out code, and it made no sense to me. I'm like, no, bro, you just don't know how difficult this thing is right now. I went literally, although I got this thing that you saying that I got access to and you didn't, I want to bang my head against the computer right now. I wanted to speed out cash, but all I'm doing right now, it's like, oh man, it's dying. You know, it's like, you know, they would tell me, yeah, go read Think and Grow Rich and work on your mindset. I'm like, dude, I've been reading Think and Grow Rich for the last 3 months, and all I've been doing is a lot of thinking, not too much reaching. You know, how much of it do I need to read, you know? But it's all a process, guys. It's all a process. And then when it's all start coming together, it's like, oh, it's beautiful. They were right. And now I'm saying the same thing to you guys that's watching. It's like, hey, you know, work on your mindset. It's the number one thing that's what's going to carry you through the journey. If you don't have the right mindset, you're not going to stay in this stuff long term. And you're going to quit. You're not going to succeed. And you're going to say, hey, this stuff don't work. While it's working for me, I'm not that special because, like I said, I used to be that guy. Like, the person you are right now on the other hand, that was me. Like, 3 years ago, 4 or 5 years ago, that was me. I was that guy. I didn't have the results. I was always asking, what the hell is going on? Why these dudes are just crushing it? They had the experience that I didn't have, you know? But I had the energy. I wanted it, you know? I wanted it just as bad as they had it. So, kind of transferring the message into you guys to let you guys know, hey, it's not impossible. It's going to happen for you. And some of you are already winning. So just keep crushing. Just keep winning. Appreciate you guys. Theben, appreciate you. Ronald, what's going on? Pound that pow. Yo, what's going on, man? So if you guys have any more questions or anything before I just get off here, get a few stuff going. And what's going on, Terry? Yo, it's funny. Nefertari, how you doing? Nefertari used to be part of my previous team with the company that I did. The last team I built, she was part of it. And she can tell you, like, this is not the first time I'm building a team. And it was the first time that I built a youth team when Nefertari was part of my team in the last business that I had to build a team. And I kind of step away from the industry of building team because, you know, it can get crazy with a lot of expectations and stuff like that. And I started building just my business, just what I do. I mean, it's been great. And it was just time right now. And I felt like, hey, let's get back into the team building because I love the people. You know, I love you guys. I love working with people. I love seeing people go into the process and still shows me, yo, this stuff still works. You know, I love seeing other people change their lives, which is the reason why I do this stuff, which is the reason I'm so passionate. What's going on, Crispy, Christelle? So, just to say that in one word, don't quit. You're part of the No Quitters team. Although I've already seen some people who say, yo, I'm out of here, man, it doesn't work. No quitters, you know? Winners never quit. Quitters never win. So pound that. Stay in the game, right? Never stop grinding. Until you don't have to grind anymore, you know? Don't stop grinding until you don't have to grind anymore. And now it becomes easy because you've been in the process. You've been in the game. You understand the in and out. And you guys are all superstars that's watching. So hopefully this video was valuable to you. You know, I can keep going here for hours with you guys. It's fun. I love doing this. It's awesome. So, but I got to get back into running my stuff, getting a few stuff going. And then, you know, I let you guys get back to running your business and making stuff happen. So like I said, guys, if you can't spend money in ads right now, use your energy. You're not starting with nothing. Like a lot of people say, I'm starting with nothing. No, you have passion. You have energy. You have vision. You're not starting from scratch. You're not starting from nothing. Because when I started, that's all I had. I had no money to spend. I had no social capital, no operating capital. But I could speak. I had passion. I wanted this. I had a vision for my kids. You know, I didn't have kids then, but I knew life was going to happen and I was going to get married. I was going to have kids. So, you know, I had a vision. So you're not starting from nothing. You know, you have your time, which you can leverage. You have your courage. You can leverage. Right now you have your passion. You can leverage. So you're not starting from scratch. Don't let people say, hey, you're starting from scratch. Or, you know, this person, they might have a list, they might have some other things, and you know, but you're not starting from scratch. If you have a vision, you have a passion, work that. Work that until the other stuff comes into fruition, because that's the most important piece, is your vision. Without it, you'll not succeed long term. Khalif asked me, how long did it take you for you to make it? I haven't made it, man. I'm still in the process, bro. I mean, I've been in this process now for the last 5 years, but I haven't made it. I don't see myself as making it. I'm still striving just like you guys. You know, I have mentors who's literally crushing the game, and I want to be like them. And when I ask them, you know, how long did it take them to make it? And they ask me, make it where? I haven't made it anywhere. You know, it's always a goal, man. It's just enjoy the journey so that you don't feel like the destination is what matters, because the destination doesn't really, it's the journey that matters. You know, sometimes we feel like, oh man, I just want to be a millionaire, and then I'm just gonna I'm just gonna chill, I'm just gonna relax. I just wanna get a million and then life is done. It's not true, you know. The process, if you look back, the process is literally, the journey is really what matters. Once you make $1 million, it's like, oh, okay, I made $1 million, now I need to make two. So yeah, appreciate your content, yo. Thanks, Kater. Watch Kater's videos on creating new habits. It will give you energy. Awesome video. Yeah. Thank you, Tyree. Appreciate you. Guys, it's a process. It's a growing process. Like I said, my first video sucked. But as I keep making them, it becomes a habit and you get better, you know. And if you do something else, blogs or whatever you choose to do, just create a new habit and keep doing it. What's gonna happen? You're gonna get better because your muscles will strengthen. Your mind muscle will strengthen. Because when I was making my videos, my first audience was actually my wife. She was my girlfriend then, you know, then we got married. She was my wife. And I always told her, babe, I really don't understand. Why can I speak to you like the way I'm speaking right now, right? I can become passionate like this. You know, I can change my mood in a second. Like I can literally flip my stage, you know, in a second. I was able to do that with her first before I could ever do it on camera or do it in my videos. Because when I was doing my videos, it's like I knew everything I was going to say. I would write it down. I felt passionate. I get in front of the camera, nothing. It's like nothing is coming through. Like, what the hell? Like, I was just rehearsing this thing in the mirror. I thought I had it. And it made no sense. When I get in front of the camera, I just froze. Like, my mind froze. Oh, my mind started running 300 miles per hour. And I didn't know what I was saying. And I always told her that. Even though I had made hundreds of videos. And I always told her, like, I want to be just as comfortable. Like, I am with you right now. Like, I'm speaking right now. To be in front of the camera like this. Why can't I be like this? But it's a journey, you know? And as I grow and progress in the journey, I figure out that I can let go. I can be at ease. I can let go of the thing that I'm thinking. I can let go of my fears. I can let go of the things that I think people might think about me, or people that's on the other end might not be receiving the message or the stuff that I need to share, or, you know, or people might be judging me. You know, I have to let go of all these thoughts that was in my mind and to focus into developing myself. And the more I read, the more I make videos, the more I grow, the easier it became. And I could tell you, it's not until this year really that my life really has changed when it comes to, you know, to the video. I mean, some people will get it a lot faster. Some people will get it a lot quicker. You know, it's just, some people will just have to, we all have to go to different process. We all grow at different state. We all grow at different pace. And I can tell you, man, it's going to be life changing. It's going to be life changing. You know, now I was afraid that what if I could get 1 million subscribers on YouTube? What if my message can reach 1 million people? And I started thinking, why not? Why shouldn't my message reach 1 million people? Like some of you that's watching right now, you're going to develop yourself into leaders where your message will impact the world. Like, your message will impact people all over the world that you just don't know it yet. You got to start. You guys can hear my kids in the background. They're going crazy. But once you start and you start understanding, you start leveling, you start going to a whole next level, and then, boom, something happened. You start getting to a whole new realm now, and you start understanding that I'm worth it. You know, I'm worth it. Like, some of you are building this stuff. Like, we have so many limiting self-belief, even through church sometimes. You know, some people right now, they don't even want to make money. Why? Because they might have to pay more tithes at their church, and they don't want to do that. Some people, they might not want to make more money because they don't want to pay too much taxes, or money is kind of bad. You know, everybody don't talk about it, but everybody wants it. You know, like, someone came to me the other day and said, yo, Kater, why do you always speak about money, money, money? I'm like, dude, like, you know, money's important to me. And he said, oh, shouldn't you be in church? Like, money's not important. It shouldn't be important. And I told him, why don't you quit your job? If money's not important, just quit your job. It's just that, you know, it's not that important. I mean, to me, it's not as important as God. You know, God is way more important because money's a tool, okay? I'm not going to sell my soul to get money, because I totally understand the concept of money. It is man-made, it's man-created, but you need to have it. You need to have the ability to understand how it works and how you can, you know, how you can attract as much of it in your life, so that you can take your life in the next level. How long did you do this before you left your job? I left my job. I did this for a year. I was still working my job. You know, I was, you know, like, I was literally, you gotta put up your grind. Like, Resi Monet asked me, how long did I do this before I quit my job? You gotta go on your grind. Like, before I quit my job, I literally did this for about a year, because I kept my job income, and then I was making money online, which was surplus to me. It was like, oh my God, like, I could make this money online part-time and still get a paycheck from the job. Shoot, why not? So what I started doing was, I was trying to fill in my days with how can I find time to work my business and then work a job. And then I was going to school for nursing at the same time. So I was going to the hospital for clinicals and all that craziness. But in the meanwhile, I saw the potential. I saw the potential. And the one thing that I think that we're not teaching our kids or our generation or people that are entrepreneurs, they are people that are changing the world. They teach their kids this word, the word of opportunity. When you understand opportunity, and it doesn't matter where you are in the world, you know, if you're watching this, you know, this opportunity is for people that's in the US and Canada, but, you know, people that's on my YouTube channel, when I speak to them, and I have people all over the world, and maybe they don't have access to the type of technology or whatever that I do, but if they look around them, look for opportunity. Once you can open your eyes to opportunity, something that can create a return, something that can elevate, help yourself elevate yourself, something that can bring income on an easier way. How do you strategize this? You know, if I go to a community right now, let's say internet was gone, I had no access to the internet, I was living somewhere remotely and somewhere foreign in the countryside. So if people needed water, like, you know, if water was the need at the moment, this is an opportunity for me to create something amazing. I would literally take my income, you know, gather as much money as I can and create some type of water filtration, some type of system, create an opportunity based on the need. See, when you understand needs and opportunity, you can create an income forever in any place, anywhere that you go in the world. And that's the one thing that you gotta teach your kids, because what's gonna happen, life is gonna keep changing, right? Things are going to keep changing. The world will keep evolving. The opportunity we have today, it won't be the same thing tomorrow. But if they learn how to take opportunity versus just go work a job or go take whatever that's given to them, if they learn the word opportunities and they learn how to spot them, they can quickly turn themselves into, you know, into amazing people that change the world and also make a lot of money without relying on someone else to give them a paycheck. So I realized that while I was going to school. So therefore, I saw the opportunity on the internet. Then I started making money online. I did not quit my job because I just didn't feel too comfortable just quitting my job and just jumping into this thing full time. So I kept on working my job and I was going to school. So what I ended up doing, I ended up quitting school because I started making more money online than my teacher. So it was like, yo, my teacher was making $40,000 in a year. And then I made $40,000 in 6 months. And I was like, oh, holy smoke. Like, if I can make 40K in 6 months, I wonder what would happen if I quit school and built my business full time. So I quitted school. Like, I went to an event, I quit school, I met with a mentor of mine. And then the next month, I started putting something together. I made my first $100,000 online, $100,000 a month. I remember making my first $100,000 a month online, and I was like, oh my God, like, this is crazy. Like, you can't actually make this type of money online. Like, this stuff is life changing. And it was crazy. And ever since then, I quitted school and I quitted my job. And it was like, okay, that's it. I'm going to do this thing full time. I can see the opportunity. I can see how this thing can change my life. So, I mean, you don't have to just boom, pull off your job, because what you need to understand, one of my mentors told me, is to add income stream. You need to focus on adding income stream. Right now, if you have an income stream at your job, it's producing income. Don't destroy it to go get another income stream that you don't know you're not certain of. Like right now, you might be just starting this business. You're not certain of. You don't know how to build it. You're in the process of learning. I want you to focus on your business more than you focus at the job. Well, someone say focus on yourself more than you focus on the job or the business, because you gotta do personal development, you gotta grow yourself. But if you start focusing more, okay, you go do your job, do what you gotta do, because your job is only helping someone else. Do the best at your job, I should say, right? Because the better you could do something is always best. Do the best at your job, then now come home and work your business. How can you create that business to grow, to replace your income that you're making at your job? If you can make income now that you're making at your job through your business, there's no reason for you to keep the job if you don't like it. I mean, if you love the job, you love what you do, just keep it as another side income stream and keep bringing more income and keep building your business. Now, if it doesn't give you the time, you want to go on vacations, you want to do other things that the job is not allowing you to do, now you can build, you know, multiple streams of income with your business, and you can just, hey, you know, you could do this thing that you want to do. But I say now, take the money from the job, invest it into your business, because your business is what's giving you the future that you want. So if you start thinking about, hey man, I want this future, my business, my job obviously is not gonna do it. That's why you're trying to build a business. So you know that you're living paycheck to paycheck. So there's no way you're gonna be able to get that future you want with just working a job. So what you really wanna do is to take the money you make from your job, invest it into you. Invest it into your traffic, your leads, invest it into books. Start learning and start growing your mind, because your income will only grow in comparison to how much you grow. So the more you grow as a person, the more your income, you start thinking big. There's a book called The Magic of Thinking Big by David Schwartz, Magic of Thinking Big. If you read that book, you know, go get that book, buy it for yourself. Start reading that book on how you can start thinking larger than life. Start thinking bigger than you have small little thoughts, you know. Our president right now, I don't know, a lot of people don't like him. I don't know if you like him, Donald Trump. He said something, if you're going to be thinking throughout the day, okay, if you're going to have a bunch of thoughts throughout the day, why not make them big ones anyway? And he's so right about it. If you're going to have a bunch of thoughts coming through your mind through the day, why not make them a bunch of big ones anyway? Because you're going to end up attracting big things in your life when you start thinking big. And in that book, The Magic of Thinking Big, that's what Schwartz, I forgot his first name, I think it's David Schwartz, he talks about that inside of that book. So either way, what I'm saying is that take the income that you make from your job, invest it into your business, and grow your business. Because keep your job, it's an income stream. Don't destroy it. Keep your job, add another income stream, which is your business. And now once that income stream starts picking up, you start making more money, you start growing. Okay, now if you don't like your job, you can add another income stream to that and keep building those income streams. Because the more income stream you have, the better off you are. Because what's gonna happen, sometimes this income stream is not gonna work as well as this one. Or maybe you might get fired from your job. But then when people get fired, it's like, my life is over. I remember when I got fired from my job, it was like, holy smoke, what am I gonna do? Like, I have to get another job. So all these months that I trying to get another job, go to interview and all this stuff, I was broke and disgusted. Because I couldn't provide, I couldn't make any money, I had no side income stream, nothing. So that's why if you have multiple streams of income, doesn't matter if one of them is kind of slow, or if one of them kind of revoked, or if one of them is not working, you have multiple streams of places that you can make money from. And that's what I teach people. You know, I teach people, like, you guys can get started in here, but that's not all. If you want to become a millionaire online, you're going to learn how to create multiple streams of income. You know, you guys are just getting started, which is cool. You know, let's hang in here, start making some money, start getting stuff flowing. But as you guys progress, right, as you guys start making progress, I'm going to show you guys how to really win big, like how to start making the big money online, how to literally start making the millions, like how to start hitting the millions. Like, I remember when I used to hang around my friends, it was like, nobody was talking about making millions. Everybody was like, oh, let's get a $40,000 job or whatever, $30,000 job. To me, million or millionaires or people that make millions, it was like, oh, it was like, oh, you know a millionaire? Oh, like someone say they make a million. Oh, I was like, oh my God, it's like impossible. It's almost impossible. Until I got into this realm and I saw kids that was 18 years old making million. Like kids that was 21, they are making millions online, and they had skill set. And they had proof to back it up. And it was like, oh shoot, I can become a millionaire too. So it started sinking in my mind. And then before I know it, boom, things started happening in my business. And we started crushing it to a whole next level. So Anyway, guys, I didn't mean to keep going like crazy. There's a bunch of you here. Okay, Feben say I just got two more leads. They are slowing, increasing. Okay, I have to figure out how to respond and follow up effectively with that and autoresponder at the moment. Any ideas, suggestion? Write your own message. Just be you. I mean, people are looking to join people in business. You know, just be you, you know. Just be you to your list. You know, to my people, like for those of you that's on the line right now, you know, I'm not trying to fake anything. I'm just being me, you know, in the process. And you guys can appreciate that for my transparency. And it's the same thing. The person that's on the other line trying to do business with you, they want to appreciate your transparency. You know, they appreciate who you are. So if you do a webinar, if you do a training for them, if you do a video, you send it to them. Hey, it's my first video. I hope you appreciate it. I'm not that great yet or whatever. So, you know, people just learn to appreciate the process, you know. So just be you with them to increase sales. You know, the fastest way you can increase sales is to get them to know you. Get them to know you and what you're doing. Where are you in the process? And then boom, it's going to start increasing conversion. So, but anyway, guys, appreciate you guys. Hopefully you guys find massive value in this video. If you do, like it. I mean, you don't have to share it. You can, since out of the group, you can share it if you choose to on your wall. But anyway, guys, that was Cato. Appreciate you guys. I'll see you guys on the next one. See you guys later. Bye.